Hey, I don't know if you realize this or not, but everybody worships something. We all have something that we worship. Now, worship isn't just something that occurs like in a mosque or a temple or a church or some religious place. No, worship is something that we do anytime we give our attention or our affection to something. And the same is true in the context of Christianity or following Christ. Like, anytime you give your attention and your affection to God, it's worship. There's a worshipful moment. Worship is this idea that there is something that is worthy or holy or beyond and that deserves our affection. There's something transcendent or beautiful about describing the goodness of God, the peace of God, the love of God even, that really does change who we are. And while worship is for God, it benefits us. There's this mutual reciprocal kind of experience in worship, in singing and clapping. And, you know, the Bible talks about shouting and kneeling and bowing and playing with drums and cymbals and using instruments and all these other things. I mean, the Bible is really descriptive. And the reason the Bible is descriptive of the kinds of things to do in worship is because the person who is getting the worship, the person who's receiving the adoration, the person who's receiving the praise gets to determine what is worship. So you don't get to define worship, and I don't get to define worship based upon a style or a preference. It's actually based on the person of God who says, this is what worship is. It's like with my wife, like she has a certain love language. And when I use that language or that mode of communicating my affection and my love for her, it means so much to her. But if I were to use my love language to help her or to express love to her, it won't mean near as much. So for me, one of my love languages is gifts. Like, I love giving gifts and receiving gifts. It's one of the languages of love that just helps me know that I'm valued and that people are thinking of me. So it's something that I love. It makes me feel valued and loved. Well, for my wife, one of hers is encouraging words. And so if I'm always giving her gifts, but never telling her that she looks beautiful, never telling her that I love her, never telling her thank you, never expressing with my words those things, well, I'm not communicating in a way that matters most to her. It's what filling her love tank. She gets to define what love is. The same is true with God. God gets to define what worship is, what love and affection is. And so you don't have to be at church. You don't even have to be in a song necessarily. Worship is anytime you turn your attention and your affection towards God and to God. And so why don't you take some time today and just turn your attention, your thoughts, your mind, stop and think about God, but then with your words begin to describe and articulate some affection that you have for God, how he loved you, saved you. And when you do, when you give him your attention and your affection, there's something of his presence that shows up in that moment, and it touches your heart in a really special way. And it's a shared moment that you get to have with God. It's personal, and it's supposed to be. And so God gets to define what worship is. So take some time and worship him, and not worship the other things that you give your attention and your affection to that are less worthy than God, who is ultimately full on worthy of all that we could give him. So take some time, attention and affection, give it to God. Hey, I love you. Have a great day.